I'm Matt Pichard here in Los Angeles for REIT World 2019, NAREIT's annual conference. Joining me today is Dave Schulte, Chairman, President, and CEO of CorEnergy. Dave, thanks so much for joining us.
Glad to be here.
Now, how would you describe the capital markets environment for the oil and gas industry, and does that create opportunities for CorEnergy as we head into 2020?
You know, REITs generally are affected by the sectors that they serve, and in our case, the energy sector has had a very challenging capital markets environment the last several years. That creates a lot of opportunity for CorEnergy because we provide an alternative way for companies to finance their permanent embedded assets, where we own them, we'll buy them from them, and then lease them back to them so they retain operating control. That differentiates us from lenders, from other debt markets, and from the common equity markets that they're otherwise subject to. We think provides them a way to use their existing balance sheet to reinvest in growth, and that's a high need for capital in the energy sector today. So we're solving a challenge that they're facing.
Now, turning to the acquisition market, what are you expecting in terms of number of acquisitions in the coming year? And are there any certain geographic markets that you're keeping an eye on?
Well, for the reasons I just mentioned, lenders have been introducing our financing options to their clients, and they're really inviting their clients to come talk to us about alternatives. What might we do to supplement the regular way capital structure that these energy companies have? So we believe we can close 1 to 2 new acquisitions in the next 12 months in this environment, and that would be a healthy amount for us. Geographically, we would expect to be diversified across the United States. We're right now focused on, we have an offshore asset, we have an onshore asset, we have oil and gas both exposure. I would expect us to continue to have diversification across commodities and across geographies with the acquisitions we're looking at. We're more interested in the criticality of the assets we own to the production that the company has, less so to whether it's specifically one commodity or another.
And finally, what are some of the ways that CorEnergy has shored up its balance sheet as we head into 2020?
Well, we took the opportunity in the last quarter to refinance some of our debt, and we're able to extend our maturity cycle out 6 years. That environment to us is very important because we own long duration assets with long-term cash flows. To have a duration matched our liability stream is very critical. And the current market environment where investors generally are looking for yield and for safety, we believe our debt securities provide that to the market, and we're fortunate to take advantage of that. So today, we have no real material near-term maturities. We have a significant amount of liquidity on our balance sheet, around $250 million, which is significant for us. And we believe we positioned ourselves very well to execute on those acquisitions we're looking for in the next year.
Great. Dave, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for the opportunity.
For more from REIT World 2019, be sure to visit NAREIT's website, REIT.com.